Hi there and welcome to another session of Business Studies with me, Vishwanath Sir. Our journey in excellence towards case studies will continue for the 12th standard because it forms a very integral and a very important part of the question paper. So again, as I repeat, go through your chapters thoroughly, understand those points clearly so that you can correlate it with the answer. So the primary objective is, of course, to score the marks, but when you enjoy writing a paper, it is much better for you to that you are doing something which you are not forced to do so. Okay, so my sincere request is please read the chapters properly before you are attempting the case studies. I continue the case studies with directing this week and continue with them and understand certain concepts more clearly. So I come to the first case study today, and the first case study today is related to Narottam Das, the managing director of a large scale steel company, remains busy in his office by making plans and policies. He does not find any time to talk to the workers or listen to their suggestions and grievances. In order to solve this problem, he appoints a person who regularly interacts with the workers and helps them to improving their performance and addressing their day-to-day problems. Identify the management function discussed here. Of course, the management function discussed here is directing. Which element of directing is stated in this case? You could tell the element of supervision is stated here. What role has been assigned to the person appointed? Quoting in the above statement, you can tell the supervisor will be a link between the managing director and the workers, who will regularly interact with the workers and help them improve in the performance and address their day-to-day problems on time. Okay, so this is your case study number one for today. As I go to the next case study where Mr. Ramaraju, who is working as a marketing manager in a large-scale manufacturing company for 10 years. He was senior among all the departmental managers. Ramaraju was popular amongst his subordinates and colleagues. He had good relations with the top management of the company. On the retirement of the current managing director, Ramaraju was hopeful that he would be selected for the position. The management, however, appointed an outside candidate for the post of managing director. Ramaraju felt demotivated and his performance was adversely affected. Why did the company appoint a managing director from outside? The company does not find Ramaraju suitable for higher responsibility positions. Hence, they appointed someone from outside. What were the reasons for Ramaraju being demoralized? Because he was not appointed as a managing director, so he felt demotivated. What was required to be done to improve Ramaraju's performance? He needs to be motivated and for improving his performance, because once he is motivated, he might probably be of great use to the organization. Okay, from here we go to our next company, Welby Limited. Welby Limited is a leading company in the automobile sector. The production department is working efficiently, but the sales has declined due to the entire entry of new companies into the market. The management does not give cash incentives to the workers due to the reduced sales and cash flow problems. The workers feeling demotivated and their performance declined considerably. With the fear that the company may now close down in the near future. What was the reason of the low performance of the workers? You can tell that the cash incentives which was given earlier to them is now withdrawn. How to motivate the workers again? They should be offered financial and non-financial incentives so that they are motivated again. How to correct the how would you correct the problems of the company? Okay, the marketing department has to take over. The management has to improve the marketing department. They increase the sales. They have to increase the sales, and that would improve the cash flow problems automatically. Okay, so this was something in related to Wellbe Limited. From Wellbe Limited, we go further and understand how Mr. Sunil Wadhwan, who was joined as a production manager in the machine tools company, he instructs his supervisors dealing with various section to take their decisions themselves. After some time, he started receiving complaints about poor quality of products, reduced production and increased wastage of material. What type of leadership was being followed by Mr. Sumit Wadhwan? He was following the laissez-faire style of leadership. Did the leadership followed by Sumit Wadhwan suitable for this organization? No, because the supervisors took advantage and they were not able to control the working of the sections. What should be done to improve the working or production department? They should follow certain rules and regulations as far as their responsibilities are concerned, and the supervisors need to be fixed for their performance. Okay, so this was Mr. Sumit Wadhwan. Now we shall relate some small things towards communication, because communication is a very important part in our day-to-day life. And here we go to Mr. Sunil, who is working as a marketing manager, and Mr. Amanda, who is working as a production manager in the electronics. Both managers are not in talking terms with each other. Because of this reason, they do not transfer complete departmental information to each other. The working of the company is suffering due to their personal problems of the manager. Identify the element of directing expressed in the above statement. We can of course tell it is a directing of communication. What factors are leading to the behavior of such managers? It is distrust or it is psychological barriers. The distrust between the sender and the receiver acts as a barrier to effective communication. If both the persons do not trust each other, then the message will not be understood by them in the original form. Okay, going to next. Kavita recently joined as a human resource director of Arjun Vidya Mandir School, a senior secondary educational institution. She observed that the school had an experienced medical team on its payroll. They regularly offered useful suggestions, which were neither appreciated nor rewarded by the school authority. Instead, the school outsourced the task of maintenance of health records of the school students and paid them a good compensation for their services. Because of this, the existing medical staff felt disheartened and stopped giving useful suggestions. So first, discuss which communication barrier is identified. Okay, it is a communication barrier due to the organizational policy. State the category of this communication barrier. So this is again an organizational barrier because it arises from the organization structure, authority, relations and rules and regulations. Going to the next question, explain any two communication barriers of the same category. One is status difference, because the status difference runs in the hierarchy of the company, and a superior may not rely on the information which is given by the subordinates and may disregard his suggestions. Second is the rules and regulations may not free flow of information at various levels. Because they are rigid, they become barriers to communication. From here I go to Sundaram, who is a sales representative at Omani Limited, has changed seven jobs in the last 1 year. He's a hard-working person, but he's not able to finalize deals with the consumer due to his inadequate vocabulary and omission of needed words. Sometimes he uses the wrong words, because of which intended meaning is not conveyed. All this created a misunderstanding between him and his clients. Identify the communication barrier discussed above. So here, of course, this is badly expressed message. Second is, state the category of this information barrier. This is a semantic barrier. Explain any other communication barrier in this category. So you have symbols with different meaning, faulty translation, unclarified assumptions, technical jargons, body language and gesture deciding. Okay, so these are certain things which you need to pay attention on, and how to tackle with them is also a very important fact. We go to two friends, Mohan and Sohan, who are working in Surya Limited as a production and sales manager. In an interdepartmental meeting, Sohan informed Mohan about a change in the marketing policy of the company. Okay. First question is, identify the type of communication used in the above example. So this is formal communication. Name and explain two networks of this communication as identified in part A. You can tell a wheel network and circular network. From here we go to Ram and Malik, who are working in the same organization but in different departments. One day at lunch, Malik informed about Ram that due to computerization, many employees are going to be retrenched soon from the organization. Name which type of communication is this. Name any two limitations also. This type of communication is informal communication because it's not in the official flow of lines. Second is, the limitations of informal communication is it consists half-truths and distorted information. It need not be the exact matter. Secondly, inaccurate information may bring more harm than good. Then, no responsibility can be fixed from the origin of the information. So, no proper decisions can be taken on this basis. From here, I go to the employees of Sangam Limited, who are free to interact with anyone in the organization for various queries and problems. This practice has resulted in a loss of secrecy and confidential information being leaked out. What system do you think the manager should adapt to improve this system? A. He should follow certain formal communication systems. The employees should follow a chain of command while interacting with others. The prescribed channels of communication should be adapted, and the employees should not approach anyone for queries and problems. Formal communication will ensure the confidentiality of the information if such informations are recorded in the office by some responsible manager. From here, I go to Rahim, who's working in an enterprise on a daily wage basis. It was difficult for him to fulfill the basic needs. His daughter falls ill. He had no money for his daughter's treatment. He had to meet the expenses of her treatment. He participated in a cycle race, won the prize money, and the cycle company offered him a permanent pensionable job, which he happily accepted. By quoting the above lines of the paragraph, identify the needs of Rahim that were satisfied by the offer of the cycle company. Of course, physiological and security needs, because it is a pensionable job. Also explain any other two needs. You can talk about social affiliation needs and esteem needs, because it gives him a self of self-respect that he has got a permanent position. From here, I go to Kundan Enterprises, who conducted a behavioral study of 150 people employed in the organization. The workers were divided into two groups of 75 each by the manager on the basis of their performance and incentives. The first group of 75 workers were praised by the manager for their initiative for new ideas. They were given flexible working hours and they were paid higher wage rates. The second group were criticized for their poor performance. They were paid a lower piece wage rate and the increments were stopped. Identify and explain the features of motivation which are given in the above case. One is positive motivation and the other is negative motivation. What type of leadership is followed by the manager? Justify your answer. Of course, autocratic, because he for the good incentives is praising, for the bad ones is punishing, and the positive motivation is giving them good incentives, promotion, recognition, while as in the negative, punish for the demotion, laid off, lower wage rate, so that they improve in the future. Okay, so please go through all these case studies in directing, and you will find it better when you attempt a paper. Thank you so much. This is Vishwanath sir signing off.